Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to work with the Law of Sines, where we have to solve a triangle where we're given the angle, side, and an angle. And in this particular example, we're given angle A of 60 degrees, side C of 90 units, and angle B of 40 degrees. All right, we're going to begin by solving for angle C. We know that the interior angles of a triangle should add up to 180 degrees. So we know that we have an angle of 60 degrees, plus an angle of 40 degrees plus angle C should add up to 180. 60 plus 40 is 100. We continue with the equation, and we see that if we subtract 100 from both sides, that angle C is 80 degrees. So let's add that. All right, now we have all the angles inside the triangle, and now let's move on to using the law of sines to figure out the lengths of sides A and B. Well, the law of sine says that if I take a side and then take the sine of its opposite angle, that's going to be true around the triangle. So here we have side A, its opposite angle is 60 degrees. So I take the sine of 60. So the fraction created is A divided by the sine of 60. That's equal to side B divided by the sine of the opposite angle, in this case 40. And that's equal to side C, which we know is 90, divided by the sine of its opposite angle, which is 80. So all these fractions here, or ratios, are equivalent, and we're going to use that to help us solve for A and B. All right, so let's start with side A. So we have A over sine 60, and I'm going to set that equal to the fraction that's completed, that where I have all the information. So that's side C and angle C. So that's equal to 90 over sine of 80. Now I have a proportion, and to solve that proportion, I just cross multiply. So I have A times the sine of 80 is equal to 90 times the sine of 60. I have to solve for A, so that means I'm going to divide both sides by sine of 80. And that's just a rule of algebra, that I'm going to isolate the variable, and whatever I do to one side, I must do to the other. So we're left with the sine of 80 divided by the sine of 80, which evaluates down to 1. And we find out that A is approximately 79.1 units. And we got that by inputting this fraction here into the calculator to evaluate. All right, so we have A at 79, at approximately 79.1 units. Now we're going to solve for B in the same manner. We know that B sine over 40, I'm sorry, let's write that neater so we can make better sense of this. B divided by the sine of 40 is equal to 90 divided by the sine of 80. I could have just as easily used the information for side and angle A, but since we're already given the information for side and angle C, I'll just use that for this example. But either way, you would still come out with the same result. All right, I have this proportion, so now I cross multiply. So I have B times the sine of 80. Set that equal to 90 times the sine of 40. All right, to solve for B, I need to divide both sides by the sine of 80. And again, using the rules of algebra, we know that evaluates to 1, leaving us with B being approximately 58.7 units. And I'm going to add that to our diagram here as well, 58.7. All right, so we just used the law of sines to solve this triangle where we were given an angle, a side, and an angle. Alright, and that sums it up for this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name, Speller Tutorial. And thanks again for watching.